What we really have to do is think about where are these points going to be compared to the points that we get here. So just a quick review, like, why is the output of this function for negative 2? Why is the output 2? Explain that, Sean.
Because the absolute value of 2, negative 2 is 2.
Absolute value of negative 2 is 2. So how do we know, like, what does the absolute value mean?
Take how far it is away from how far away it is from 0.
Is it 2 to the right, 2 to the left? It doesn't matter. Just how far away is it from 0? Okay, so negative 3 is 3 away from 0, and positive 3 is 3 away from 0. One of the most useful things about this graph really is that it shows us transformations of graphs pretty easily. It's got a really distinct shape that changes for us really nicely in ways that we can visualize pretty easily. So if we use the absolute value of x minus 2, right, g of x, but you notice part of it is just taking the absolute value of the number, right? So part of it is exactly the same as the output of f of x. Picking up what I'm putting down there?
Yeah.
Makes sense, okay? So we have the first part, like the absolute value of negative 3. If I put negative 3 in there, like g of negative 3 is the absolute value of negative 3 minus 2. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Look, right? That part is right there. So all I have to really do to find g of x is take f of x and do what with it? Subtract 2. So this becomes 1. This becomes 0, negative 1, 2, 3, wait a minute, not right, negative 1 again, 0, and 1. So what does that effectively do to this graph? Sean?
It drops it down to.
Drops it down. It's 2 lower than f of x. Get the idea? Any questions about that? Okay. Let's try thinking about it kind of in reverse. Graph an absolute value that looks like. Absolute value of x, we're taking that output, we're adding 3. Okay? So we're kind of just messing with the output of this function. Output is y. Y is vertical, right? We're messing with the output, we're messing with vertical shifts. Okay? So if I have some function equal to the absolute value of x plus some number, let's call it k. What happens when I add k onto the function? What happens to the graph? Somebody new. Somebody newer. So the absolute value of k of x, when we add a number, just like we in the previous examples, in the first one we added 3 here. In the one before that, we added negative 2. Okay. And so when we add a number on after the absolute value x, what does that do to the graph? John.
Moves the plot,
yeah,
up or down
on
the y.
Yeah, it moves all of like 100% of those infinite plots up or down, whatever k is. Right? If k is positive, it moves up. If k is negative, then it just looks like subtracting, right? And that would go down. So it goes up k. Now what if k is negative? Would it still go up k units?
Nope.
Wouldn't it though?
Yeah.
If I go up with a negative number, I actually would go down.
True. Mm-hmm.
If I go this way, negative 2 miles an hour, I'm going this way. So if I intend a direction, and then I say a negative number, I'm actually going the opposite direction.
different kind of an alteration to this function.
So we know what f of x looks like if f of x is the absolute value of x. Got that basic v shape down, right? So g of x, where the absolute value of x plus 5.
Okay, think about that.
I want you to give a prediction in your mind. Notice the plus 5 is inside the absolute value. So you don't take the absolute value until you add 5 to the number. You don't take the absolute value and then add 5, like you just did before. I want you to take a prediction in your mind, just think about it, I think this is going to happen. Then, put some numbers into this function, plot the points, see if you were right. That's all I'm going to do. I'm just going to plug numbers in for x, you're going to get some numbers out for y, and we're going to see what that graph looks like. Alright, so when we added something after the absolute value, or if we added a negative number, it's like subtracting, it went up and down. So when I threw this up there, who wants to share what they thought would happen? What they thought would happen to the graph when we added a 5 inside the absolute value.
I thought that it would move over to the right, then or to the left.
Okay, so you thought adding 5 moved to the right, right? When we added something on outside, it moved up, and we subtracted, it moved down. All right. When we add 5, it would make sense inside the parentheses, because it's kind of like messing around with x, where before it was messing around with the y value. Okay, now it's kind of changing what we think the absolute value of, and so it would make sense to shift to the right. What did you plot some points and discover anything? Or did you even have time? Let's see, who else thought it's going to shift to the right 5? And if it was minus 5, it shift to the left 5. So fair enough.
Well,
you had some other guess?
I'm starting to plot it, and I did 4 points, and
yeah.
I got like, it's starting to look like it's moving to the left.
To the left.
To the right.
Seems weird.
Yeah.
Okay. Sean's right. It will shift to the left. So let's just plot some points, and we'll find out. At least that it does shift to the left, and not to the right like you might have thought. Okay. Here, let's think about this. Like, where this thing has definitely like a middle, right? Did you say there's like a middle to this shape, the point of the V. Where does the point of that V happen?
-5.
Of this one.
Oh.
Zero. Like when we plug a zero in there, when we take the absolute value of 0, well, we know numbers on the left of that are going to see the left side of the graph. Numbers to the right of that are going to see the right side of the graph. Let's show you the table here. Right? 0, 0, -1, 1, 1, 1. Even when we shifted it up and down, still, when 0 is inside the absolute value, we see the middle where that symmetry happens. So Sean, would you say, like, what's going to give us a 0 inside the parentheses here?
0 for g, or the x?
Not 0 for the x, but 0 for the inside of the absolute value.
I think it's, let me check, it's -5.
-5, right? Because, well, that's the absolute value of -5 plus 5. That's the absolute value of 0. What's the absolute value of 0?
0.
Let's see if we move to the left and the right of -5 if we get symmetry. -6, -7, let's go -4, -3. The absolute value of -6 plus 5. That's the absolute value of -1. The absolute value of -1 is?
1.
Let's plug in -7, -7 plus 5. Absolute value of -2, which is 2. Let's see what happens on the other side. -4 plus 5, now that's the absolute value of +1. The absolute value of 1 is? -3 plus 5, the absolute value of 2, which is 2. So that center piece, that V shape, the center of that V shape, that line of symmetry, that vertex, moves over here. to negative 5. Moves to the left 5. So, I'm going to draw this in a straight line. Like that. Like that. You can see I'm right about that. Negative 5, comma 0. Negative 6, comma 1.
Negative 6, comma 1.
Negative 7, comma 2. Negative 4, comma 1. Negative 3, comma 2. So, kind of defies our instincts that it would shift to the right 5. See, that totally makes sense. You would think it would shift to the right 5. Then it winds up shifting to the left 5. Who can explain exactly why does it shift left instead of right 5?
I think it might have something to do with the absolute value.
Something to do with the absolute value? Okay, so maybe we see this kind of flipping around and going against our intuition because there's an absolute value. I can tell you that's not the case. Like, pretty much every function we have, if inside the function we were to add 5 to x, it would go to the left 5. Okay, other functions like x squared, that's going to move to the left 5. Even functions like linear functions or x cubed or the square root of x. Anytime you put a plus 5 inside that main function, like square root of 5, or the absolute value of 5, it's just to the left 5. What do you think?
Maybe because it's to get g of x, you have to add 5, so g of x is 5 less than x.
So what Cadence is saying is we have this plus 5 here, right? So to get the values like we did in f of x, we have to put in x's that are 5 less. Is that right? The numbers that we plug in for x, actually we have to use x's that are back 5 to start to see the same kind of outputs we got from f of x when we just plug in 0, 1, 2, 3, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, right? Like for f of x, if I want to find the center of that shape, I would just do f of 0. Because then I would take the absolute value of 0, and I would get 0. But to get 0 in g of x, what do I have to plug in for x? Negative. I go back here to negative 5. So the inside of the absolute value is actually 0, giving me the center of that V shape, like I did with f of x. Let's try one similar to that. Actually, then maybe let's try it in reverse. Got this guy here, drawn the absolute value function, but it's shifted a little bit. See if you can write this function, call it h of x. Call it h of x equal, seeing as it's over there, 3 to the right. Okay, so this graph itself is shifted which way and how much?
Right.
To the right, 3. Okay, let's just jump back real quick. When we plotted the points for the absolute value of x plus 5, with the plus 5 inside the absolute value. It shifted to the left 5, even though we might have thought it would shift to the right 5. This one shifts to the right 3. So what do you guys think? Great?
Comma would be x minus 3.
When you say minus 3, is that inside or outside?
Inside.
Inside the absolute value? Okay.
Feel like that will work, but let's just double check.
So you think that the center of this thing should be at 3, like this formula, this function should produce an absolute value V shape that's centered around 3. Okay? Well, if it's centered around 3, then our table should show that. So the center of this thing should be somewhere, it should be right at 3. And we should see symmetry on the left and the right of 3. That make sense? So if I plug in values to the left of 3 and to the right of 3, the outputs should mirror each other. Well, let's see what 3 gives us. That's the absolute value of 3 minus 3. Absolute value of 0 is 0. That's a good sign, right? You notice that every time we take the absolute value and we get 0, what does that tell us about the graph?
That's where the point is.
Yeah, that's where that point is. Called the vertex, right? That's where that vertex is. So the vertex is going to be found wherever, after I take the absolute value, I get 0. Yeah, that's right. Now let's back up a couple, right, to the left. To the left of 3 are 2 and 1. Absolute value of 2 minus 3, that's the absolute value of negative 1. Absolute value of negative 1 is
1.
Absolute value of 1 minus 3 is the absolute value of negative 2, which is 2. So we should see it mirrored on the other side of 3 at 4 and 5. Absolute value of 4 minus 3?
1.
1. Absolute value of 5 minus 3, absolute value of 2, is 2. That's exactly what I see right there. Sean, you got a half question or just a stretch? Good. Makes sense to see how those points line up with the graph?
Makes sense.
Good.
Thanks.
Okay. Good. Let's see if we can put a couple of these together. So I'm going to have you graph the function. I guess we'll make it a, not f, q of x is equal to the absolute value of x minus 4 plus 3. So the value of x minus 4 plus 3. In other words, there's two changes to the graph.
You want us to graph this?
I would like you to graph, see if you can graph it, maybe without plotting points. Okay? Can you tell where it would wind up being and kind of where it would V off from there? But if you want to plot points, absolutely plot points. I've never discouraged you from it. But let's see if we can try drawing the graph and then plotting the points, see if the points land on the graph you drew. So if I were to cover up that plus 3 part, it was just q of x equals the absolute value of x minus 4 inside the absolute value. What have we learned that does to the graph? Any news? Grady?
Wait. So
if it was just the absolute value of x minus 4, forgot about the plus 3 for a second, what would that do to the graph?
Well, we just have to, it would just be on the 0 line, right?
Well, we've got a couple of examples, like, here's an x minus 3 inside the absolute value, right? What did that do to the graph?
It moves to the right.
3. So what do you think? We ignore the 3 for just a second.
It moved to the right.
Moved to the right 4. Okay. What would, by itself, plus 3 on the outside of the absolute value do? If it was inside the absolute value, yes, but it's outside. Right, so it's like after you've taken the absolute value, now you add 3. So where does it go?
It went to the right 1.
By adding 3?
Yeah.
Let's jump back to, well, here we have absolute value of x plus 3 on the outside of the absolute value. We have absolute value of x plus 3 on the outside. What did that, how does that graph look to the graph? Like,
it went up 3 on the y.
Up 3 in the y direction, right? So together, minus 4, moving it to the right 4, plus 3, moving it up 3. Well, let's try it both ways. Let's just move it, draw it how we know the shape should be if we move it like that, and then we'll plot some points, see if we're right. So we'll move it to the right 4. So the right 4 and up 3, right? What should I find there? Like, what part of the graph should be right there?
The vertex.
Vertex. And I would expect it to see it go off with like this slope of up 1 and over 1. And in this direction, up 1 and to the left 1. That's what I think that's what the graph will look like. I think it's centered around 4. I think the center of it's going to be around 4. So, I'm working off that assumption. I'll make 4 the center, and I'll go 3, 2, and I'll go 5, 6. That's the value of 4 minus 4 plus a 3. Well, look what happens. You got 4 minus 4 inside the absolute value we have. 0. When we take the absolute value of 0, what did we note from before? When we take the absolute value, what do we know about our graph? That's where what? Where the vertex is. Yeah. So when we take the absolute value of 0, that's where the vertex is. So we were right about that. When we plug in 4, we're not taking the absolute value of 0. When we take the absolute value of 0, we know we found the vertex. But it's not 4 comma 0, is it? It's 0 plus 3. So that's why our vertex is at 4, 3. It would just be to the right 4, but then we add 3, so it moves up 3. Absolute value of 3 minus 4, well, that's 3 minus 4 is negative 1. Negative 1. Absolute value of negative 1 is 1 plus 3.
4
is 4. Going over 1 and 1, just like we have in the past. 2 minus 4, negative 2. Absolute value of negative 2 is 2. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 minus 4, that's positive 1. Positive 1 plus 3 is 4. 6 minus 4 is 2. We get 5, right? 2 plus 3 is 5. If I were to plot those points, I'd have 3, 4, 2, 5. Before we run out of time, let's get out those cards. Okay? Got those cards out. Okay. You want the answers to your plan? Alright, so decide if you think the graph of the absolute value of x plus 6 should look like graph A, B, C, or D. Okay? If you think it's D, for instance, you look at your thing here, you find the letter D really faint right in gray. So for me, D is the top here. I'll just hold it up so D is right side up. Right?
Yeah. Oh, no.
Just as an example, this is what D would look like for me. Okay? So you think it's graph A, B, C, and D. Point that letter of the answer that you think it is up in the air. And now I'm going to scan the whole class. Yes, good. Gotcha. Gotcha. You. And you.
Yay.
Okay. So what do we got? 9, 10, 12. Should have got 15. That's my fault. So I didn't get Jacob's or Monica's or Sean's. Huh. I don't know what I did wrong, but we'll fix it. But it looks like most of you. Would be A. Would be A because we added 6 on the outside of the absolute value. We got a couple more. Don't put them away. Moves it up 6. Okay, let's try another one. Absolute value of x minus 3. Okay, so hold them up high. Let me see them. Let me get the right question. Okay, hold them up nice and high. We got this. Nice and high. That's yours. Okay. Come on now. Okay, got it. See yours? Huh? Gotta hold them up high and straight. Okay. Waiting on you. Okay.
Wait, who's D? I'm going to have it D.
flip it over. It'll change it. Okay. All right, yes, good, 12 of you. It is D. Okay, just like adding 6 on the outside, moved it up 6. Subtracting 3 on the outside, moved it down 3. One more. One more, just a few seconds. This guy right here. Last one, A, B, C, or D with a plus 2 inside. The absolute value. Change your mind?
Yes.
Okay. Looks like the vast majority of you. What does it be? B. It moves to the left 2 because it moves that center to -2. To get 0 inside the parentheses or the absolute value, -2. Thanks a lot, you guys. See you tomorrow. Have a good day.